that too hard or it'll start ripping the paper. Somebody's got to help me with this lack of music. I'm dying here. Maybe I'll have to do this with headphones in or something. And no, I'm not going to sing to you. I'm gonna need to re-wet down here. I haven't wet too much. So it's still kind of dry and secure. To the dulcet tones of traffic outside my window. There we go. I'll give it a minute to soak in down here. This has been intermittently wetted for a while, so it should be bit better. Ugh. My micro spatula is getting all gummed up from this glue. That's so gross. Let's see if I can clean it off. Entirely water soluble. Awesome. I don't want to take a gummy end of a micro spatula and stick it down in the paper. I'll just be transferring some of the glue to a new spot. And when it dries out, I'll have to deal with it all over again. So I'm going to try and keep the spatula clean or keep keep it towards the spine here. I find some good bugs in this. I'm not exactly an entomologist, but I enjoy finding the different kinds of bugs in old books. I think it's amusing that people see a bug skittering across the page that either frightens them or surprises them, and they slam the book shut on the bug like I do. Not really afraid of bugs, but when they're bothering me, I will squish them. For some reason, the spine of this signature's shredding as I'm working on it. I'm trying to keep it from doing so, but it just doesn't want to cooperate. I did take a look, though, to see if, I don't know if you can see it, this paper there belongs to this signature or this one. And it does appear to belong to this one, so I'm going on the upper side of it to try and keep them together. Make sure we don't have any paper issues in between these signatures. It's getting really gummy in the center of the spine here. I don't know if you can see it. Must have applied a lot of glue from there and spread on out. These are really good for working very fine detail. Don't often need it, but they're handy. some more magical solvent. You can see with the water that I've introduced to the spine, it started the paper to swell as compared to down here where it's still dry. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get these apart and I'm going to clean them as best I can physically. And then I will put them in a bath, pretty much just distilled water, and I'm going to allow all the fibers to swell all together at the same time. And then I'll take them out and I'll put them under pressure so that when they dry, they're drying evenly and at the same time, so you don't end up with pages that are buckled strangely because of the uneven wetting. So it'll clear a lot of this buckling out. It'll smooth out the edges, and then I'll use some other paper to give some of the edges reinforcement if they need it. Like I said before, this is my own volume. I'm not working on a client's piece of work right now, which is good. I'd love to be working on a client's book right now, but I don't mind doing work on my own stuff. It gives me more practice, and if I screw up, I don't have to worry about it. I will have to do some research though. This is how the volume came to me, so there are no end papers. I'm pretty sure that the end papers were just another piece of this paper. But I'll do some research and see if I can find this volume, an example of this volume published in 1800, and see what it looks like. Because, I mean, if I'm going to restore it, I want to try and restore it to how it was when it was first published and released. And there are some companies that still make this kind of paper the old-fashioned way, just for this reason, so that doing conservation and restoration work on old books you can replace with very similar, if not the same, type of paper. The color is probably going to be different, but we'll see if we can wash some of this leather dye out of the spine and this grime from handling and water damage, and see if we can get it back to as close to white as it used to be. Of course, they wouldn't have bleached it. This wasn't a fancy volume. I mean, it was bound in leather, but practically everything was bound in leather. So they wouldn't have worried about bleaching the pages. It's 1800, so, you know, this isn't printed on vellum or anything. So they're not going to put a lot of effort into making the paper bright white like we have all our paper now or anything like that. It would just come out in whatever natural color the paper maker had of cloth. Spot. I'm really glad to see that it is water soluble though. especially considering how much glue they applied at this part of the spine. Got a paper trying to join the other signature. Gotta watch that or else you'll end up ripping it the whole way down the spine. Which is something you can mend, it's just a pain in the butt to do it. And it also compromises the paper. I mean, it's not gonna ever be as strong as it was when it was just one piece. This one, I don't know if you can see it, but it's trying to join the other signature, so I've got to try and make sure to keep it with its original signature. There we go, nice big piece. Anyone want some old disintegrating leather with a tiny, tiny bit of gold leaf on it? Yeah, I don't know if you can see that, but that's the animal hide glue that they used to put this all together with. It's pretty gross. Fortunately, it doesn't smell, at least not yet. Maybe it's just too old and doesn't have much scent anymore, or maybe they processed it so it wasn't so stinky. It's interesting, the backing paper is only at the two ends. It makes me think that they had a headband glued to it, and they just glued on a headband. Because I don't have any backing paper throughout the rest of the spine. It's just the leather straight onto the paper with glue, which is interesting. Most of the times they just use misprinted paper, trash paper, to put on the spine, between the spine and the leather. And it's really cool because there's some paper you'll be looking at that doesn't belong to that book. It was misprinted, or it was, you know, just kind of junk throwaway paper, so they use it for that. So you end up with whole pages of paper from an entirely different topic lining the spine instead. I have a book on the history of Methodism, and the paper that they use to line the spine is about trains. This looks like a train wreck now, but it's because of all the gunk left over from the leather and the glue. We'll get it cleaned up and it'll look a lot better. Let's see if we can get this glue off before it dries. It glues everything back together again. I'd actually like to read this book once I get it into a place where I know that handling won't make it fall apart. I'd like to know what they think of the history of America as far as 1800 went. I mean, there's not a whole lot of history before that, so it makes me wonder how in detail they get into certain events. It's bound to be entertaining in any case. Walpole, New Hampshire. I'm gonna get my duller tweezers. I don't want to start poking holes into the spine of some of these papers. Stabbing holes into paper is not a good way to go. 217-year-old paper. Yeah. If you have any questions, please feel free to put them in the comments. I'd be happy to answer as well as I can. No questions. That's cool. Now this is a thrilling, on the edge of your seat watch. It'd be very satisfying to watch something get cleaned and totally fixed though. See if I can get recentered here for you. I'm just going to gently scrape up some of this glue and remove it while it's still soft and pliable. God, that's so gross. cardboard yet. And some bigger pieces will help us have a little bit of a less of a mess to clean up. I don't know, can you see that? This needs to be rewetted. Well, let's get some of this out of the way. If you think about it, you and I are the only people to be seeing this part of the book for 217 years. I know there's nothing really amazing painted on it, but I think about things like that when I'm working on old books, seeing part of it that no one's seen for so long. Gotta keep rechecking the camera, make sure I'm centered so you can see it. Go. Oh, shit. Oh, man. I was doing so well. That's the bulk of the leather that was left on it. Let's get some of this crap off. Starting to dry out and the glue's becoming gluey again. give it to them, though. I mean, 217 years ago, they made glue that held on this tight. It lasted this long. Really, really gross glue. I don't know though, I suppose once glue is used, it becomes gross right away. I don't know. What do you think? The act of use changes glue from being useful into being gross. Welcome to Deep Thoughts from Paper Conservators. Where here we ask pointless questions and speak like Bob Ross. Yeah, look at this. Look at that. Bookworm damage. He made it a ways in too, didn't he? There we are. Well, the material's so dry he can only make it through three pages of it. Maybe I should take that as a hint. I'm gonna grab a paper towel and start wiping this up. It's almost lunchtime. In case you're wondering, I am speaking to my lab assistant. Literal lab assistant. Yes. Say hello to all one of our watchers. To make sure that I don't work too hard. There are mandatory play breaks here at Moore Archives. Get you positioned again. Some of that cleaned off. That's much better. Something other than my hand to wipe all this crap on. See if we can identify some separate signatures here. There we go. So gross. Got some clouds. Let me see if I can. There we go. And once you've got the glue wet, it's just kind of squeezing up from between the pages. This one's not too bad. I mean, I've worked on a book that had about twice as much glue, and that one I practically had to shred the spine to get it off. It was not pleasant. It was also from the early 1900s, so it was a wood pulp paper, so it was already falling apart. So we're starting to get down to the color of the original paper now. That's exciting. Are you excited? I'm excited. This is exciting. So, for the one person who just joined us, I'm removing what I believe is animal hide glue from a book that is 217 years old. It's a water-soluble glue, and so I've applied distilled water to the spine to soften up the glue to remove all the leather that was left there. And I'm trying to remove some of the glue before it dries and glues everything back together. But like I've said before, if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments and I'll address them as they come along. I'm being as gentle as possible because I'm trying to conserve and restore the book and the paper. And I want to do as little damage as possible. I mean, I could have just ripped all that leather off easy and got on with my day, but it would have done a lot of damage to the book. And that's not my goal. Lost a viewer. No, sorry, this is not a game. I realize that Twitch is primarily a video game viewing medium, game playing viewing medium. But I thought I'd give this a try, see what people thought, see what I think of it, see how it comes out. Coming along, and then I will take all the string out. I'll take all of the signatures apart as soon as I take care of the rest of this. Yeah, you can really see the gold leaf. That's really cool. It was barely visible before. Let's get a fresh fold of paper here. I'm not adding more glue to it instead of taking away. So this glue, when it's moistened, it turns into this weird yellowish gel. It's pretty gross. I'm not sure how much detail I'm streaming through here, but identify where my signature is. I've got a piece of paper trying to switch sides. There we go. And don't worry if you're bored, guys. I'm gonna try and see what I can do about getting some music on here or something while I'm doing this. That's what I generally listen to while I'm doing this work. So hopefully future videos will not be quite as yawn-inducing. You do have to admit, I mean, there's some level of satisfaction watching all this crap come off the book. And I need to moisten that some more. Hello. Sorry, I just now saw the comment. How are you today? I'm just applying some water to the spine here. I'm removing what I think is animal hide glue. It's water soluble, so I'm softening up the glue. You always want to use the least abrasive product that you can when you're trying to save something like this. So fortunately, water will do it. And it just turns this glue into this yellowish brown gunk, which I can then get off the paper. Oh, my day's going all right. It's almost lunchtime, so I figure after I get all of this off, I'll stop streaming for a little while and take some lunch. But sun is shining and it's been a pretty productive day so far. The leather's coming off of this better than I expected it to, fortunately. Did you have any questions about what I'm doing here? Can separate out some of these signatures. I am working on restoring a book that is 217 years old. I saw it in an auction and no one really wanted it because, well, this is how it came. And so I thought I would take a try at restoring this. This is my company, Moore Archives and Preservation. Yeah. And so I'm going to be taking the book apart. I'm going to be cleaning it. I'm going to be doing whatever mends need to be done. I'll be flattening it, and then I'll sew it all back together and give it a cover. Thanks. I really like it. It can be a good challenge at times, and I like the fact that every book is different, so it doesn't feel like I'm doing the same thing over and over, fortunately. Yeah, that's my company. I've got a webpage, moorearchives.com. You can go and check out some of the other stuff that I've done. I work primarily out of Virginia and the surrounding area, so DC, some South Carolina, or North Carolina if there is any, Maryland. But so far, most of my clients have all been in Virginia, so mostly Virginia stuff right now. Did you hear that? My dog is snoring. She's very ladylike. I've got to add some water to this end so when I move on to it, it's already softened and ready to go. Unfortunately, the ends of these have been exposed for who knows how long, so they're really shredded. Not as bad as... No, this end was a lot better. There's going to be a lot of mending I'll need to do with this. Man. You see the yellow paint there? It makes me wonder if the headband that had been there was painted yellow or something. You learn a lot of stuff about these old books when you start taking them apart, especially when you get as up close as I do. So, since there's yellow there, might have been a yellow headband. So when I rebind the book, I'm gonna see if I can use yellow string. I generally do the binding itself with linen, and then the headbands I'll do in silk. It's kind of traditional for the time, if they had silk, to do the headbands with them. And if you don't know, the headband is generally the weird little sewn fabric roll that you'll see at the end of a book there. finally done, and then you can see me rip out all the sewing. The brown is leather, so I have to be careful trying to pull that off, but the blue is paper, so that's going to be just scraping off just like the glue. Yeah, that's easy enough to take off. Thank you, Captain from Milan. I appreciate the cat faces. For my other two viewers, if you have any other questions, please chip in and let me know. The spine is nearly done. Getting so close now. The stains on the pages, I'm going to put them in a bath. And I know that sounds kind of funny, but I have a tray, and what you do is you put this paper in between two different bits of a special kind of paper. It's actually a polyester blend, and it's made so that nothing sticks to it. So when the paper is in there and there's glue and other stuff, it's not gonna stick to this paper, but this paper will help hold it together and keep any sort of abrasion or anything from tearing this paper apart. So it'll hold this paper still. And while it's in the bath, I'll keep changing out the bath water, and it'll slowly start lifting off all of the dirt and some of the minerals and hopefully the dyes that bled into it from the leather that was along the spine. So hopefully I'll be able to remove most of the color damage that's been done to the book over the last 217 years. Some conservators end up using bleach. You can actually bleach the paper to get it white-ish again. I mean, this paper was never white. And this is about, you know, as clean of paper as they ever had. So I can try and bleach it back to around this darkness, but the problem is it's going to bleach the ink too, and I don't want to do that. So I don't generally use bleach when I wash and clean the papers, but some people do, and it can be very useful. Just get a little bit more of this animal glue off before I let it dry up again. The sewing is already coming out, so the signatures are already starting to come apart. Each group of pages that are folded all together like this is called a signature, and you sew them together one by one. The cool thing I noticed about this is that it was sewn onto cords. The cords have completely disintegrated, but the stitching is still there. So whatever sort of medium they used, sure, now I can't lift it up. Whatever medium they used to stitch with is stronger than the cords that they stitched them onto, which is cool. And in restoring these old books, I found that the cord disintegrates really fast. I mean, relatively. But the cord usually, or the string they use to stitch it all together, usually remains a lot longer. So now, let's rip out the stitching. Don't worry, it won't be that violent. I'll clean this up a little bit though. So yeah, that's the spine right there, what's left of it. A little tiny bit of gold leaf, a lot of rotten leather, and a disturbing amount of really disgusting animal hide glue. I haven't found any bugs yet, but the part that comes after this next part, I will see. I've got to take the signatures apart, and then one by one I'll take all of the pages apart and start looking at them to assess their damage and how much cleaning they're going to need and how much mending. And usually when I'm not streaming, I've got my blog app open on the phone and I'm taking notes on like which pages need mending and what needs to be done so that I don't forget. All right, so let's rip out the stitching. If you look at the oldest book you've got on your shelf, chances are that it's really falling apart. The after 1850, they started producing paper out of wood pulp, and unfortunately, the lignin that's present in wood pulp also gets acidic with water, and the acid slowly starts eating through the paper. So that's why. Thank you, Captain Fremulon. I appreciate the input. The acid starts eating through the paper, and that's why you find a book from the early 1900s and it's just crumbling to pieces. An old newspaper is like that too. But even though this is 217 years old, it's in really good shape, and that's because this paper isn't made from wood pulp. It's actually made from a mixture of cotton and linen. When people would make stuff, make clothing or whatever with cotton and linen, they'd have rags left over and they'd take these rags and recycle them into making paper. So I'm just going to start removing some of the sewing. The string that they used to sew it together, it's got, I mean, the kinds of fibers coming off of it, it looks like it was probably linen, which is still traditional today. Anyone that's hand binding a book now, a lot of people will use linen cord. I've still got glue on my fingers. So I'm just gonna go through and really gently remove all the stitching from each signature. So you can see at the center of each signature, I mean, this is one piece of paper folded over onto itself. So here you can see where the stitching comes through. If I just pulled on it from the outside, it would tear through the center of this, tearing all these pages apart. So that's why I'm trying to be as gentle as possible. Because I can mend them, I can put them back together again, but it's not going to be as strong as it was originally. Really good quality paper, though. I mean, it's not the best, but for what they had at the time, it's not bad. I'm just glad it's not I'm glad it's not parchment. I wouldn't have the first idea how to deal with parchment. I should probably take a class in that or something. So we start to see how these are put together. And that one's still attached, so I'm just going to snip it so that I don't end up ripping any of the paper. You can see at some point it was stored at the same place as other papers and stuff, so you get strange little snippets of papers from something else. I don't know. But I'll set that aside. I'll save it. I don't know how well you can see, but there's a lot of dirt in my crack. Yes, I said it. So I'll work on cleaning that out when it's dried. And here I've got a piece of his signature, not sure which one it belongs to, but it's split all the way up the spine, so now I've just got a single page that I have to figure out how I'm going to reattach and put back in its place. I'm glad the pages are numbered, though. I've worked on some old almanacs that weren't numbered, and the last one I did was in German, and I do not speak German, so that was an adventure trying to put it back together because I couldn't read it and it had no numbered pages. I think I got it put back together right. I should probably have someone check my work when that happens. There we go. And one thing I can do with this after all the cleaning and mending is done is I can check and see if it's under copyright, and if the book isn't under copyright anymore, I can digitize it and put it online, which would be pretty cool to do. It's something that I would do before I sew it back together, just because, well, it's easier to scan flat pages than it is to scan a whole book. So is that. Yeah, this is linen. It's nice stuff. Yeah, you can see this signature's had a lot of damage over time. This spine is really ragged. So in the mending of this, I'm going to go through and lay down some paper along this spine and glue it in place to reinforce it. Yeah, put my card back out there for you. Interesting thing, when you're going through, you can really see where some of the printing mistakes are at, like this here. Part of the word is totally obscured by an ink blob. And sometimes you can clean it off if it wasn't done at the same time of the printing, but if it was, then you're kind of screwed. Yeah, like here. I can't remove that extra ink. Not without, like, ripping out part of the paper, so. And the more you know about ink, the more you'd be able to tell that that was, you know, their bad in making the ink, or if it was for some other reason, maybe they did the printing too fast, they rushed it too much. I haven't found any bugs yet. Kinda disappointed. It's almost my favorite part of processing old books is finding the bugs that people have squished in the pages. Now this is kind of cool. Right here you can see it's part of the paper, so it looks like a fiber of wood or something fell into when they were making the paper. And so it stayed there, but the book being pressed together for so long, because wood has acidic compounds, it's gone acidic and it's actually stained the opposite page. And what you see here is this was the very edge of a sheet of paper that was made. So instead of cutting that off, they're making the best use of the paper they can. So you've got the very edge of the paper that they made here, which is really cool. You don't see that very often. Yeah, got it again here. It's not as obvious as it was on the other side, but you've got the natural edge that's left. Gotta pull it through. A little bit. Yeah, and here's where they tied it off. So it's the tail end of the string. It's interesting, they leave a lot of resources, notes on resources at the bottom of this page. So nowadays you can write a book and entirely publish it and not have to put your resources in there, but 217 years ago in a crappy old book that was printed on the History of America, they cite their sources. You see it? Let me see if I can pick this up. What is that? It's flexible. It almost makes me think of a feather, but I don't think it's a feather. I think it's a piece of grass or something. That's kind of cool. I'll put that along with my random piece of paper to save. If I can get it off the tweezers. There's the knot. This knot was tied approximately 218 years ago. I think stuff like that's cool. Not everyone does, but I do. I've got two signatures that just do not want to come apart now. If that's a tear, I'll just have to mend it later. See if there are any extra strings. I don't see any. So, there you go. I've removed all the binding, and I've taken out all of the stitching, and now I have all the separate signatures. Now the next step is to go through and start separating them out one by one, each page, and separating them from one another. Because the last thing I need is for everything to dry and that glue to set again, gluing everything back together again. So I would just have to get it wet again to take it apart. Contents: Spirit of Adventure Awakened in England by Columbus's Discoveries. Expedition from Bristol under the command of Cabot. Man, I bet they'd spin in their graves if they knew what we thought of Christopher Columbus now. Yeah, but this is a really good example of the kind of damage that a page can overcome. Or undergo over time. This is one piece of paper. So this is the title page, and this is the other half that was folded in. So if I'm very careful, I can wash the two sides of this paper together, and hopefully get this lightened up a little bit closer to this color. But there's been a lot of damage to this paper. There's probably a lot of acidic damage. There's water damage. There's you know, damage from the dye in the spine that I've only helped increase because I had to wet the spine. But yeah, it's interesting to see how paper can change over time. All right, so I think I'm gonna stop there and grab some lunch, but I will resume afterwards when I keep processing this. So thanks for tuning in.